So we know in previous classes we have learned about it. So we need to represent a ratio number, negative ratio number on the number line. So that is minus 5 by 3. This minus 5 by 3. How to represent? To see that, let's find out what is the numerator part of it. It's minus 5. The numerator part, it's a minus 5. So let's find out where is minus 3, minus 5 on the integer line. So we are going to find it, just we have taken the integer line. So we represent an integer line. So that is positive values, negative values, and up to 0. So numerator part, we have seen that is minus 5. Let's find out what where is minus 5 on number line, on integer line. So here is the part which is minus 5. This is the minus 5 on the integer line, the numerator part, the numerator part of it. So we took. And now let us find out what is the denominator part. The denominator part of this ratio number is 3. So 3 is the denominator. We always need to remember that when the denominator is 3. And let's divide this number 9 by 3. So all the numbers let's divide with 3. So 0 by 3. So it's nothing but 0 only. Value of it will not change. And this is divided by 3. Divided by 3. Divided by 3. And let's divide by 3. Minus 5 divided by 3. And 6 by 3. And 1 by 3. 2 by 3. And 3 by 3. 4 by 3. 5 by 3. And 6 by 3. We know that 0 by 3 is nothing but 0. And the next number, 3 by 3 is 1. We'll be getting 1 here. And 6 by 3 is 2. And here, 0 by 3, already we have reached 0. And 3 by 3, minus 3 by 3 is minus 1. And minus 6 by, minus 3 by 3. And here, 2, we have divided by 2. Make sure this is 2. So we have reached 2 there. And now, and this is minus 2, we'll be getting. And if you observe the numbers on the number line, this number line, it's the same integer line, but it's divided into some of the parts. You observe here, there is a 0, and 1 and 2, it's an integer line, and this is a minus 1 and minus 2, and this is an integer line, positive values and negative values are over the 0, and here, the part between 0 and 1 is divided into 3 equal parts. You observe here, 1, 2, 3, the 3 parts are divided. You count from here to here, 1 part, 2nd part and 3rd part. So, and one number is divided into 3 equal parts, so that is nothing but divided by 3. So the numbers which are between one number and another number, and it's divided into 3 equal parts, so we have written divided by 3. So then now we can observe that there is minus 5 by 3. This is a part of minus 5 by 3. This is a minus 5 by 3. And now in this similar way, we can find out any ratio number on the number line, either it is positive or negative. Let's take some other example. That is, minus 56. The denominator is in. And the numerator part is 7. 7 by minus 56. So we need to represent this one on the number line. So let's see how to represent it. So we need to write any number, any ratio number should be in the standard form. So this is not in the standard form. The reason is we have discussed earlier that denominator of the ratio number, the denominator of the ratio number should be positive, and if it has any negative value, we need to take it in the positive. You have to take it the numerator part. By dividing plus divided by minus, minus divided by plus, or minus divided by minus in that form, using the properties of the signs. So here there is a plus sign. Actually, there's a, if you don't write a plus symbol for any number, so plus divided by minus, it's nothing but minus. So we write minus divided by 56. Minus divided by 56. So now this became standard form of a ratio number. So now this number we need to represent on the number line. So let's draw an integer line first. So because this is a negative number, this negative integer. So let's draw it. integer, positive values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Negative values are minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, and minus 7. These are the negative values, and positive values are the right hand side. Negative values are left hand side, as we know that. So, 0 in between. So, minus 7 by 56 is the negative ratio number. And if you observe the numerator of this ratio number, the numerator part of this ratio number is minus 7. Let's find out where is the numerator here, this number line. So let's see, negative number on the number line, it lies on the left hand side of 0. We know already, we have learned in previous class, that is negative side will be left hand side of 0. This is the 0, left hand side of it here. So there is a 7 here, minus 7, we plot this number. So minus 7, just represent it. So we have plotted this point, minus 7. But it's not only the minus 7, minus 7 by 56 we need to take. So always we need to remember that is divided, the number is divided into 56 equal parts. The number is divided into 56 equal parts. In the previous problem we have divided into 3 equal parts. So each number we divide into 3 parts. Like 0 to 1, we divide into 3 parts. 1 to 2, we have divided into 3 parts. In a similar manner, we need to divide this 56 parts. So write this all the numbers, do this all the numbers divided by 56. So each number we are dividing with 56. Let's divide with 56 now. 0 by 56, 1 by 56, 2 by 56, and 3 by 56, 4 by 56, 5 by 56, 6 by 56, 7 by 56. But here there is a number minus 7 by 56, it lies left hand side of 0. So minus 1 by 56, minus 2 by 56, minus 3 by 56, minus 4 by 56, minus 5 by 56, minus 6 by 56, and minus 7 by 56. This is the number we need to have. So we got the number minus 7 by 56. So the similar form here, we get minus 56 by 56, we'll be getting 1. Somewhere we extend this line, we extend this line to 56, and somewhere we'll be getting minus 56. Minus 56 divided by 56. If we extend this line, continue this line, and we'll be getting somewhere that is minus 56 by 56. So that value is nothing but minus 1. And we extend this line in a similar manner. Extend this line in a similar manner. We'll get 56 in the numerator, and divide by 56, we'll be getting 1 there. So and between 0, 0 by 56 is nothing but 0. So right hand side we got 1. Then we get, if we extend this number line, we'll be getting 56 and 1 there. And this side is minus 1. So this is the integer line, Between two numbers, between two numbers, we divide with the 56 parts. That means a number is divided into 56 parts. So in that form, we got minus 7 by 56. This is a representation of rational number of the number line. So let's go to the next concept, rational numbers between two rational numbers. So let's go to the next concept, rational numbers between two rational numbers. So we have two rational numbers. How many rational numbers are present between them? Let's find out. Let's take an example of two rational numbers. Keep by 5, 7 by 2. Let's see how many rational numbers are present between these two rational numbers. See the denominators of these two rational numbers, that are 5 and 2. So let's make these two denominators equal using the process of LCM. The LCM of 5 and 2 is nothing but 10. 5 into 2 is 10, because there is no common factor for this 5 and 2. So We'll take 5 into 2 directly. So these are prime numbers, directly we can multiply them to find out the LCM of it. So 5 into 2 is 10. So 10 is LCM for these two numbers. So 3 by 5, 7 by 2 to get LCM as 10 between these two numbers. We know the 5 is multiplied by 2, we'll be getting 10 as the LCM here. LCM is 10. So let's multiply and divide with 2 by 2 to get 10 as LCM. So we took 2 by 2 here, and then for the next number, 7 by 2. And here, the 2 should be multiplied by 5 by 5 to get LCM as 10. So we multiply and divide it by 5 by 5. So let's see what is the number it is. So finally, we got the two fractions that are 6 by 10, comma 35 by 10, are the two ratio numbers. And then, let's see how many ratio numbers are present between them. That are 6 by 10 after, we'll be getting 7 by 10, 8 by 10, 9 by 10, and so on. 34 by 10, 35 by 10. There are some ratios between them are present. So let's take these two numbers, 6 by 10 and 35 by 10. So there is so on. 7 by 10, 8 by 10, 9 by 10. 10 by 10, 11 by 10, 34 by 10, 35 by 10, and so on. These other ratio numbers are present. So, the ratio numbers what are present in between these two ratio numbers are unlimited. So, we can count that and see how many ratio numbers those are. So, but if you take the same ratio numbers, 6 by 10 and 35 by 10, and multiplying 10 divided 10 by 10. So 10 by 10 to 10 by 10. So the reason of multiplying and dividing by 10 by 10 is making into equivalent fractions. We have discussed about equivalent fractions, how these are equal. So in the same way, when we multiply with constant number in the numerator and denominator, it becomes equivalent to the fraction, particular fraction. So we have divided multiplied by 10. So it's equal to the fraction of 6 by 10, because we cancel this 10 by 10, we'll be getting 6 by 10. Similarly, we cancel this 10 by 10, we'll be getting the same 35 by 10. So let's multiply, write the equivalent fraction to it, that is 60 by 100 and 350 by 100. So let's see how many ratio numbers are present between these two, that is 60 and 350, 60 by 100 and 350 by 100. So we'll say that here 61 by 100, 62 by 100, 63 by 100, and so on. 349 by 100 and 350 by 100 is the last number. In this form, some of the ratio numbers are present between these two and that are countable, we can count and see. And the same process, if we continue a constant number and multiply the numerator and denominator, like multiply and divide, and we'll be getting an equivalent fraction to that, equivalent ratio number, that is 60 by 100 and 350 by 100 should be multiplied with one more 10. So it will be increased like 10 by 10. And we'll be getting equivalent fraction to that. We'll be getting 600 by 1000 and 3500 divided by 1000. So there are some of the ratio numbers present between them. That is 600 by 1000 and 3500 by 1000 that are countable. The same process, if you multiply a constant number, the numerator and denominator, the value of that is equivalent fraction, then we'll get the sum of the ratio numbers between them. The same process, we continue this process, we'll be getting so many ratio numbers between them. So what we understood here is, between two rationables, there are infinite rationables are present. So that are uncountable. We cannot count how many rationables are present between two rationables. So this is the concept. Let's go to the next concept.